Hello, my name is Hannah, and today we are building a tiny trailer for Strangerville. Now, this build took me quite a while. Not exactly this build, but I scrapped it like 6 times, which is, I do that so often. I'll get the shell done, and I'm like, no, this is ugly, and just like delete it, which is probably really bad, but like that's where the perfectionist in me comes out, and I'm just like, no, it's ugly, and I'll, like, scrap the recording, scrap the build, bulldoze the lot, and I'll start over again. And it's, like, really bad, because it takes me forever to build things that, like, are, like, really small like this. Like, this is a tiny home, so it's 55 tiles total. I don't really remember. I didn't check, because I just knew it was under 64. You can probably see, but I can't see, because it's kind of small in my, like, recording. So, yeah. So, I'm just gonna, like, not talk about the build for, like, a couple minutes, but, like, so this is for Strangerville, and, like, I know it's, like, a really, like, polarizing opinion, but I've played the Strangerville mystery 5 times, and, like, it's really bad, but, like, I just do it, like, I've done it 5 times, 2 of which were, like, speed runs, so, like, I tried to do it as fast as possible. It wasn't that good. It still took me forever, but, like, I tried, and then I just, like, keep doing it. I just, like, whenever I get, like, bored or, like, I don't want to, like, build, I just, like, do that, which is, like, I'll either do that or, like, I'll go to, like, Silverdorada. I'm not sure why. It's just, like, when I get into, like, a builder's, like, block, which is probably not a thing, but, like, I can't build, I can't, like, play the game or, like, build in, or build Sims, wow, create any Sims, I'll just, like, do that. Because I feel like it's, like, it helps, like, get rid of the builder's block. So, it's really weird. It's really bad as well, but I just, like, do that. But, like, no one, it's, like, everyone's, like, it's such an unplayable pack, but I've played it 5 times, and I build in the world all the time. So, I don't know. It's probably a really, like, bad opinion to have of the pack. But I definitely think the money was well spent there. Yeah. I have paid $4 for every single time that I've played it. So back to the build. It's a tiny home, like I said. And I went with more like a lighter orange wood that I normally go with. I usually go with like darker woods, I guess, because that's, you know, personal opinion. I prefer darker woods over the lighter woods. But I decided to branch out and I used those parenthood counters. And I never use that swatch unless I'm like building like a 70s home, because I feel like that's what those counters remind me of, but I felt like they fit really well in this kind of house for, like, Strangerville, and I don't know, I liked them, and I made, like, the entire house, like, orange, and then, like, that light wood, and then, like, there's, like, hints of yellow and, like, blue in, like, the main areas. The bedrooms are definitely different. Well, I guess, nope, the toddler's room is entirely orange, I think. I believe that's what I did. So the toddler's room, I believe, is entirely orange, but I may be very wrong. It's gonna be, like, purple, but I think it is orange, but, it's definitely a very cramped toddler's room, but it's, like, 2x3, it's a tiny house, they'll be fine. When they grow up, I don't know what they're supposed to do, that's not my problem. You could expand it, because it's still gonna be a tiny home if you expand their bedroom a bit, but, like, currently, how it is, you're not gonna fit anything else besides that bed in there. But here's where I decided that I wanted to go with more of an orange color scheme to match with the, you know, like, living area and kitchen. And I think it's really cute. I put, like, a lot more detail into it. Or maybe not. I don't really know, because it's a smaller area, so it looks more decorated. However, it might be just, you know, more cramped into an area compared to my other builds, so it might look more decorated. But I got inspired with the color scheme of this bedroom to match the other one based on that little, like, cubby thing that's like the dresser and like the toy storage. I thought that was really cute with the colors and the like orange wood, so I made the entire room orange, which is probably really bad, but like it's cute, it's a kid's room, they're fine. And so this is the master bedroom. I went more with like I think it's pretty much matches what my, like, you know, definition of Strangerville style is, other than like the Victorian. It's like more of this, like, you know, eclectic kind of style that doesn't like really go together, but it's still kind of cute. So I have like a, like, you know, that base game cheap bed. It has like those like leaves on it that are like blue and green. I like that swatch a lot. It's kind of cool. And, oh, and also this bathroom's 2x2 and doesn't have a sink in it because I needed to have a bathtub because it's a toddler. So, this you have to use the sink in the kitchen, but that's okay. You don't need it anyway. But it's definitely usable. I did play test that. The entire house is play tested. On my game, it does work. So, you should have no issues, but, every computer is going to be different because some places I've seen builds that say that they're play tested, but then they don't work for me even with move objects on, so never know. But and then I put like very sparse decorations, or like not decorations, landscaping. Well, my definition of very sparse, like I usually like go like overboard with the amount of plants. But, like, it's Strangerville, so it's a desert, so I put like these like low-lying like green cactus and like I don't know what those plants are called. Like, they look like aloe plants, but they're not. Like, that kind of plant. And then I put a tree, because there's a couple trees around the area, and there's no trees inside this little, like, fenced-in area. Or there might be, I don't really remember. But I put a couple plants, and I put a couple plants that are, like, partially under the trailer. But, like, it also doesn't look like a trailer. It was originally supposed to be a trailer, and then I made it more, like, shape-wise. Shape-wise. And so it's kind of a trailer, but like there's a car, and then like what I'm imagining is what you use to like attach the car, like the truck, to the house so you can move it. But, like, it's not on wheels, and there's no wheels anywhere around here. But I feel like that stilted foundation could be like just like what it's currently sitting on. Yeah, it's really weird. Also, I don't know how to terrain paint in this world at all, because like none of the terrain paints match. So I just like put some dirt down. And then it like looks really weird, so just don't mind the terrain paint. Like, ignore it ever happened. So here I'm scrolling through debugs, so it'll partially debug. At this point, I'm scrolling through like the regular builds, but I find this hanging plant because they added that with the Show Live Edit Objects update, and I think they're really cute for this world. And here I put a truck. I decided on orange because the entire inside is orange, and the outside is like this like peachy color. But, like, it also matches like the ground and the surroundings of the world because that is also orange. Really orange house. And here I'm putting the trash cans behind the house, so you're gonna have to like walk a bit to take out the trash, but that's okay. It's not the biggest deal. But here I'm realizing that I had a lot of money left because I was trying to make a starter home, so under 20K. Like, I had a lot of money because it's a small house, and I was using like a lot of like the cheaper furniture because I thought it fit the style more, which I was totally unintentional. I was trying to use the money up, try and make it like that style without going over budget, and it worked really well. So I upgraded some of the appliances, made the like the toilet better, and like added a shower tub combo so you didn't have to bathe every single time because it's slower to do that. And then I added cabinets in the kitchen, yeah. And then I went back to this kid's room and decorated it more because it was like really sad. So I added more toys, and then I added the potty because I usually forget that. It's not good, but like I usually forget the potty, but I put it in the kid's room because there's no room for the bathroom. Oh, and screenshots time, so I post 4 videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. So I will see you all Saturday. Bye.